Good morning and Merry Christmas. I just want to say I wish you the most blessed and wonderful Christmas season, whether it be with your friends or your family or with your neighbors, your church friends, whatsoever or whosoever you may see or go visit. Please enjoy your time this year. I just want to appreciate you for all that you've done. I'm sharing this video this time a little early. I want to share some of my favorite parts of the season. We enjoy Christmas so very much with our grandchildren, with friends and family, and we have traditions that we like to do, baking, cooking, visiting different places. You know, I just feel like this time of the year we should be so blessed, and we've done a lot this year. We've been able to accomplish a lot this year. we've had good health this year. We are so blessed to be on the face of this earth. So I want to share some things with you that we've done. We have made ornaments, we've made crafts, we've decorated trees, we've went to the park and saw the lights. We have played in our pajamas. My grandkids really love to put the tree up in their pajamas. So we did that this year. We've made hot cocoa this year. We've made gifts for people. We've even made gifts for the feathered friends outside, which was a big treat for my grandson. He enjoyed that very much. We have played Elf on the Shelf. I was very leery of Elf on the Shelf for a long time, but my husband and I have really enjoyed it this year and last year for our grandson because he gets such a thrill. It's the happiness and the joy and the thrill that he gets out of it that makes me happy. Whether he believes in it or not, it's the fact that we put it together and we have fun doing it, and then he enjoys it. So what's Christmas about? That's the point. Anyway, I hope you enjoy all of our shenanigans and all of our Christmas traditions. If you have Christmas traditions, I hope you enjoy them. Being together, loving each other, and being happy. If you find yourself alone, there's a lot of things to do. You can visit a church service. You can go and walk out in the, take a walk. Look at Christmas lights in your neighborhood. Go to the park and look at your Christmas lights. Go downtown. Most everybody lives near a town. So you can, you know, enjoy the Christmas feeling without being alone. And our thoughts and prayers are with you if you are alone. And we hope that you can make the best of every moment. Thank you for being here on YouTube with me. This is a new endeavor. I'm venturing around and doing different things, and the new 2023, I hope, will bring us more venturing out and doing things that we enjoy and doing things that we like. We feel like that. We want to continue. We want to be a self-sufficient and sustainable homestead, and I want to go towards that. I want that to be our goal this year. We're going to be doing some venturing and doing some things that we want to do. We have big ideas this year for gardening and for traveling and doing things. So I hope that you can join us. If so, then I hope you'll comment, subscribe, and like, and get those notifications. I wish you the very best Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year. I'll see you in 2023. Oh, 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 oh Good morning. Welcome to the show today. I am doing a little bit of Christmas baking. It's less than a week away from Christmas, and I wanted to do some friendship breads. So I've got little disposable pans today. We're going to do some apple cinnamon quick bread. It's just a quick little mixture. We've got some cinnamon, some flour. I've got everything I need in here already. So let's get with it. Let's start some baking and we'll enjoy the day. So like I said before, I'm ready for, I've got my flour, cinnamon, baking soda, baking powder, salt, all that good stuff in here already. It's already mixed up. We're ready to go. We're going to add our vegetable oil, our milk, our applesauce. We've got crumb topping ready. I think I'm all situated here. So just hang tight and we'll get started. And I've got my oven preheated at 350 degrees. It's a nice cold day outside. I've got the Christmas tree up. I'm ready to go. We're going to enjoy this. Got a nice cup of hot coffee. It's a really chilly day out today. It's supposed to get really, really cold. I think some of the wind chills is supposed to be in the negatives this weekend. And we're in an area where we lose power a lot. So I feel like that I want to get my baking done, even though we have a gas range, which will work during power outages. But I just don't want to waste it if I don't have to during that time, because we may even have to use it for heat, who knows. We do have backup generators and things like that, and we have backup system. But I just want my baking done. Christmas is Sunday. I've got neighbors and friends that I'm hoping to give the bread to. So I'm going to get this baked up. So what we're going to do is I'm going to use a quarter cup of water. I've got a quarter cup of oil. It's already mixed together. Some applesauce. I think this is like a half of a cup. Let's put that in there. I like making breads. I'm not real good at it, but I kind of learn as I go. I'm going to use some eggs. I think I've got two eggs here. Can't wait till my chickens start laying again. I'm having to purchase eggs. I am not happy about that at all. $5 and something a dozen. I have even seen them $6. And I'm like, come on chicks, get with production. I've had one here or there. I've upped their proteins. I've done everything I need to do, but it's the shorter days, not enough sunlight. So I'm hoping that they will start laying within the, you know, the spring, at least my March. So hopefully I can make it 2 months without eggs, although I am having to purchase them. Okay, there's two eggs. Let's stir this up a little bit. Oil, water, applesauce. It's a super quick, easy recipe, and it's delicious. It's apple cinnamon bread. You can see how pretty and dark that is with the cinnamon in it. We're also going to put a crumb topping. My recipe did not call for a crumb topping, but we will be putting a crumb topping in it. I'm just really big on the crumb topping. I just think it gives it such a rich taste and a little added pizzazz. We don't want to, most of the breads that I make, I generally do not use a mixer on. You don't want it the consistency of cake. You want it to be like bread. That's a difficult thing whenever you're, you know, you really want it a better consistency, and I tend to want to over stir, and I want to have a little more moisture in there. But breads are not like that. Okay. I've pre-sprayed my little disposable tin pans only because I want to be able to take them to the neighbors and her not have to worry about bringing them home to me. So we're going to fill this tin pan about halfway full. I don't want them like over exploding, so, because it will rise. Okay. You can see how pretty. So I'm going to stop that one. I'm going to make her two loaves. I'm hoping that this will give me a second loaf. It said on the directions, my recipe, you could get two pans out of it. Smells delicious. I'm a batter girl. I could eat batter all day, which I have. Okay, that's not quite half, but hopefully that'll rise up and make a really pretty loaf. Okay, I've got crumb topping made. This is flour, brown sugar, cinnamon, and softened butter. I use 100% butter. I just think it gives it a better, richer taste. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take and sprinkle along the top of it. On both of them. Okay, and as that butter melts, it will melt into that brown sugar and that flour and make it like a little crumb. Okay, now what we're going to do is I'm going to put it on a baking sheet because I really don't want these little flimsy pans to bend. So I'm going to put it on a baking sheet and I'm going to pop it in the oven. And I believe, I think my recipe said that it stayed in for like 50 minutes. I'm going to check it. I'm going to stick a toothpick in it and make sure that it comes out clean and make sure that they're done before I do bring them out. But I think about 50 minutes. Now I've mixed up my ingredients for my banana nut bread. I'm going to be making two loaves of that as well. I'm going to be putting nuts in this, some probably chopped up pecans, or you could put walnuts, whichever you prefer. Banana nut bread is a favorite of mine, actually. I love the bananas. I like the smell of it. It smells fresh to me. Okay, so we're going to go with 2/3 cup water and 1/3 cup oil. And of course, 2 eggs. This is the same recipe, kind of the apple bread. You've got flour, you've got the baking soda, salt, all the things that you put in to make a bread. This does not call for yeast. It's not that kind of bread. it's more of a quick bread. It's just added in things, mashed up bananas. I've got pecans to put in it. I'm I'm not going to put a lot of pecans because I'm not sure if the neighbors really like pecans, but maybe 2 tablespoons, and I'm just going to mix that up. Okay, we're ready to go. These make great breakfast, especially for Christmas, because they're quick, they're easy. You can put them on a charcuterie board. You can set them out for, you know, just all day. It won't hurt them. And it's just something very quick and easy, especially if you have guests, that you don't have to worry about standing in the kitchen all day fixing something to eat for your guests. You can give them a little bit of bread, some butter, something, so, you know, some nice hot drink, perhaps maybe even coffee, whatever. And it just makes it so much versatile. It's just such a versatile food. I'm going to put just a sprinkle of nuts over the top of this just to give it some pretty view, I suppose. Okay, there we go. We got 2 really pretty pans of banana nut bread coming up. Okay, here's the apple crumb. Here's the banana nut. They're going in the oven. Okay, let's set this timer for, oops, don't want that done. Let's do the timer. Let's go up to about 50 minutes and then we will check. Okay, there we go. Timer set. We'll wait for that time and then we will check it with the toothpick. Okay, now as you can see, I am trying to make some gluten-free things for my grandson. He can't have gluten. He has celiac disease. So I'm taking gluten-free pretzels and I am adding Rolos, which have caramel and chocolate. And then what I'm gonna do is add a pecan after these have melted. I'm gonna put these in the oven for about 5 minutes and get them melted really nicely. And then I'll stick a pecan on top and they're called turtles. So he can enjoy something too because he loves chocolate. He likes any kind of snacks, honestly. So we really do try to make him special things as often as possible so that he doesn't feel left out. I've learned a lot about gluten-free. It's not really hard. It's more time-consuming if you don't want convenience foods because it's very pricey to buy gluten-free. So we try our best to make things for him, baking, cooking, anything we do, we try our best to make sure that he's accommodated for. And I've learned a lot about it. It's been fun, actually, to learn about the different things that I never knew. I just wasn't informed enough about gluten to know a ton about it. I had to research it and I had to learn it. And once I did, it was amazing. We even eat gluten-free with him, and it tastes the same. We've not had any issues with, you know, the taste as far as, you know, something we really did not like. My husband's a little more picky than I am, so he's been a little harder to sell on it. But if you take your time and you learn and you follow the recipes and you do what you're supposed to do with it, then it's simple and it's easy. So, you know. It's not for everybody. When you have to do it, it's a thing. So, you know, we've become accustomed to it, really.
Holy Jesus. What has he done this time? Seriously? Thank you. gosh.
Holy
God. I believe he decorated the house.
Yeah. But he didn't want me. I think he was trying to
think. Oh,
no.
What? I think he got tangled up.
His hat fell off.
Well, right now I'm gonna have to clean up for my dang elf. Look at the candy canes. Yeah, they start early.
Hi-ho.
That's the dwarfs.
Dwarfs?
The dwarfs.
Yeah,
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. But there's Santa. There's the Crescent School. There's Andrew Johnson's home place. There's the courthouse. That is so cool.
That was it too.
Yes. That's cool. That's neat.
Yeah.
Look at the elves on the picnic tables.
Yeah.
I know. Yeah. I know. That's pretty high.
Look at the
car,
it says 88.
Look at the little church on the hill over there.
Aww,
it's elves. No, that's carolers.
Even look at the plane.
Yeah, see.
Look at him in the tractor. Look at the tank.
Oh, it's an army tank.
He's fishing.
Look at the little people on the swing.
Aww, this looks so realistic.
I know, it's cool, huh? Look at the tank. And Santa on the tractor.
And
fish. Look at the fish.
Even look over there.
Uh-huh.
Look.
I see. Carriage.
John Deere.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's because we have a John Deere plant here.
Gingerbread.
Speaking of gingerbread, do you want to make a gingerbread house? Yes, we need to make a gingerbread house, true. Look at the little fish jumping in the pond.
Look at her heels. That blue one.
The what?
The blue house.
Oh yeah.
Look at her.
That's the candy house.
Yeah.
How cute. I think that's some little kids playing volleyball.
Yeah, they are.
Mm-hmm.
Look at Santa. Coming out of the present. Something's coming out of the present.
Where? Oh, yes.
There's a year scene.
There's the wise men and there's the nativity scene.
There's Jesus.
Uh-huh. The nativity scene.
What does that mean?
That's where Jesus was born. And the angel, the three wise men, and the animals were. Yeah, it's got the animals. It's got Mary and Joseph, baby Jesus.
Christmas in the park.
Merry
Christmas.
What?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. I have to watch where I'm going.
You want me to do it?
Mm-mm, I'm good. Thank you.